You know, that we're going to see on Saturday.
Trinidad's in the fight.
Yeah, I mean, there's like a feud between Atlas and Freddie. They don't like each other.
Freddie and Atlas don't like each other. And I can understand. I can understand Atlas not liking Freddie Roach because Freddie Roach is a joke. For real, I'm just telling you that he that type of guy. He said that I don't like him. I don't give a damn about him. I don't like him. I don't care nothing about him. I don't get along with him, and he ain't no part of me whatsoever, and never will be. That's all I can tell you.
You like Teddy as a trainer, Teddy Atlas?
I would tell you this about it. I have never seen the thing that Teddy Atlas did. I think Teddy Atlas right now, I think Teddy Atlas is doing a good job with Bradley. I seen some good things in there that I like that. Teddy Atlas doing. I mean, I think he's doing. I'm not saying that I ain't saying that I can't do it, but I'm saying that he's the one that's doing it right now, and he's doing a good job with it.
Devin, what did you think of Broner calling out Floyd?
Actually, thought that before the fight, I said that, oh yeah, Broner's gonna call out Floyd. But I mean, I think that was a good choice of him to do that.
Devin, like he said. You said it was a good choice for him to do that?
Well,
it's a good choice for him to do that to get a good payday.
That's
the only reason it is a good choice. Other than that, it ain't even worth taking a chance. I'm just telling you that Broner and Floyd, man, come on, man. That's like throwing the sugar in the water.
I've talked to Floyd about you many times, and he always tells me that two names that will take over boxing: Devin Haney, Gervonta Davis. Why does Floyd and his dad believe in you so much?
I just got all the tools.
Hey, man, look here. You know why Floyd and his father. It's only because they know boxing. They know if these particular two guys, if they go out and continue to fight like they fight, train like they train, when they look at Floyd train, they know they already know what to do. When you go out there and train like that and do what you do, you ain't got to worry about getting whooped. You gonna whoop everybody.
Devin, he told me you sparred Gervonta. You sparred Gervonta?
Yeah, I did spar Gervonta.
How'd it go?
Oh, yeah. Like I told you then, like you want to ask him now, I done already told you, so I ain't got nothing else to say.
He already told you what happened.
And whatever I told you that happened,
that's what happened.
I'm going to tell you, that's what happened. It's over.
So that's what separates you. Too much of young with a high ring IQ.
Yes, sir.
You take your time and think like Floyd do.
Yeah. Yes, I've been boxing for a while, so I like to study old fighters like Charlie Burley. So I know about boxing. I know about the history of it, and I study it a lot.
Who are the biggest names you've sparred? Because I know you've been in there with everyone. Give me three names.
My biggest name. I sparred Zab.
Zab Judah?
Yeah, I sparred Zab Judah. I sparred Sean Porter.
No way.
He sparred Sean Porter. No contest.
What happened?
He told you what happened. He just told you what happened.
That's huge, right? He's one of the best fighters in the world.
He is.
Well, look, I'm telling you what's up, man.
You're the real deal.
The real deal.
All right, give me one more name.
I spar Rancis Bartholomew.
The guy who's fighting Mickey Bay.
Yep.
And he's super talented.
Yeah.
He's got skills.
Well, I seen Devin was getting the best of him, too. So, I ain't too much I can tell you about who done whooped up Devin, because ain't nobody in it.
Exactly.
Devin, how do you feel making your father says your United States debut as a professional here in America at this famous arena, the MGM? Is this going to be the first of many?
Yes. This is a dream come true. The average 17-year-old is probably at school right now, and I'm here at a press conference getting ready to fight on Saturday. So this is a dream come true, and I'm excited for it. So Saturday night, I'm going to put on the show. Check.
Is that true? You've already had a few professional fights down in Mexico?
Yes, 4-0 with 3 knockouts.
How was it down there? You know, those guys are tough down there.
Oh, yeah, it was good. It was good work over there. I look to go back to Mexico.
How old were those guys that you
fought? One of them was 25, 27. I don't know. I don't really worry about the age like that because, like I said, I was part of world champion. So
you ain't got to do that. You ain't got to worry about the guys. The Floyd football guys, same thing.
You're getting good. Or do you
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram @Ellie Secback.